Welcome back everyone to the series on working with a Syncfusion React Data Grid. In my previous video, you saw how to export the data grid to Excel and PDF file formats. In this video, I will show you different selection options including cell selection and checkbox selection. In my getting started video, I showed you how to bind local JSON data to the data grid and display only selective columns using column customization. I will proceed to use that same example here. You can get this example from the link shared in the description part or watch my getting started video from the card shown above. There are two selection types available in React Data Grid, single and multiple. By default, the single selection type is enabled. To enable multiple selection, you need to set the selection type to multiple. For that, let me create a constant selection options of type selection settings model. You can import this from the EJ2 React Grids package. Set the type to multiple and assign this settings to the selection settings props. This way, you can enable the multiple selection of records in the data grid. In addition to the selection type, there are three different types of selection modes: row, cell, and both. These allow the user to select either the required cells or entire row. The default selection mode is row. To change the selection mode, set its mode property to cell in the selection options. Now you can select only the cells in the data grid. If you set it to both, you can select both cells and rows at the same time. Cell selection can be of two types, and the default one is flow. When I select a cell, press Shift key and click on another cell, all the cells between those two cells will be selected. The other option is box. When I select a cell, press the Shift key and click another cell, only the cells corresponding to the columns that lie on the selection range will be selected, like a box. With checkbox selection, you can select multiple records by using the checkbox on each row. As a side note, cell selection will not work together with the checkbox selection. To enable checkbox selection, set the type of the specific column to checkbox. This will enable a checkbox in each row, and using them, you can select multiple rows. Excluding default selection mode, you can also set reset on row click selection mode. This will reset all the previous selections when the user clicks on a row. To select multiple rows, the user has to press the control button and select the desired rows. Toggle selection allows you to select or unselect a row or cell. You can enable this behavior by setting the enable toggle property on the selection options. You can set the data grid component to select a specific row during its initial rendering. To achieve this, set the selected row index property to the index of your desired row. This way, you can select the particular row during initial rendering. You can get the index of the selected rows using the getSelectedRowIndexes method. I will create a callback function for rowSelected event, which will trigger whenever the rows are selected in the data grid. To use getSelectedRowIndexes method, create a reference for the data grid component. If the grid is defined, call the method grid.getSelectedRowIndexes. This will return a number array that contains the selected row indexes. Let me summarize some of the major points we discussed in this video. First, we talk about the selection types and selection modes of the data grid component. Next, we saw how to enable cell selection and checkbox selection. Then we looked at how to toggle selection. And finally, we saw how to select a row on initial render and get the selected row's indexes. Thanks for watching this video. If you found this video useful, please give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.